Hi everyone, it's Professor Klaus, and today we're going to go over the capabilities and methods of using Final Cut Pro's Scene Removal Mask. And this new feature boasts the ability to detect background objects in your video clips and automatically remove them. This eliminates the need for a green screen, theoretically. It's not perfect, but in certain situations, it gets the job done just right. Let's go into how you can use this feature. You could add a new background. You could incorporate an animated background. You could change the existing background, making it darker or brighter to make your subject pop. Or you could also change your subject's lighting. Another way you could use it is to blur the background just a little bit to give it that nice look. Or put some text between the foreground layer and the background layer. To achieve the best results, you need to use the proper filming process. It's crucial to shoot in a well-lit environment with even lighting. It's a good idea to use light-colored clothes against a dark backdrop, positioned approximately 6 to 8 feet away. You're going to need a static camera, so you're going to need to mount it on a tripod and not move it once you've started shooting. You need to remember to record 1 second without you in the frame at the beginning or the ending of your recording. You're gonna press record from behind the camera, start recording your shot, then walk into the shot, so you've got your shot. So if we take a look at our clip, you'll notice that the first frame is the background without anything in front of it. This is good because Final Cut Pro is gonna reference that frame to isolate the subject from the background. The scene removal mask gives you 4 options to use as a reference file. First frame plus 1 second, the last frame plus 1 second, and the last frame. Its default is the first frame. In this particular case, the final frame is not an option because I picked up the camera before stopping the recording. Final Cut Pro doesn't require that the reference frame is used in the video, so you can just scrub through and find your endpoint and select it by pressing I. Find your output and select it by pressing O. You can place the clip into the project by pressing D or clicking and dragging it. Open the effects panel by hitting Command 5 and then go to the Masks and Keying tab and select Scene Removal Mask. Drag the effect on top of your clip and if you followed all the instructions, you should have a near perfect key. Now the results aren't as good as if you had an actual green screen, however, you might have forgotten one or you might not have one. So this fills in those situations nicely. One way you can use this effect is to make your subject pop from its original background. So let's drag, using the Option tool, drag the clip down to form a duplicate. With the bottom clip selected, hit Command 6 and then go to the film strip icon. Turn off the scene removal mask. Now the bottom clip will no longer have the key applied, but the top one will. With your lower clip still selected, press Command 6 to open your color wheels or color board or whichever your preference is and adjust your exposure. You'll notice how the subject in the foreground pops more than previously. You can also apply the same effect to the foreground clip. Next, let's add some text between the foreground and the background clip. We'll go to the Titles and Generators tab on the top left. For this example, I'm going to grab the custom text and drag it between the two clips, and then drag it out so that it lasts the duration of the clip. Next, I'll add some text and format it the way I like it. That looks pretty good. So for my third example, let's go up to the Titles and Generators tab and let's retap that icon. We're going to scroll down to the generators and we're going to find a moving background called Aurora 2 and I'm just going to drag that underneath. You can see how that looks. There is a paid plugin called Keyper from FX Factory and it allows you to fine tune your key. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you have any questions or if you'd like me to make any particular type of video, please leave me a comment. Remember to like and subscribe, and as always, take care.